fortunately or unfortunately, depending upon where you are on this issue, that this particular hearing is going to become moot because of the whose bill is bigger and better contest currently taking place in the Democratic caucus. But that being said,
I'm confused by, is that a, the fact is that if this bill, as it's presently constituted, is posted and receives a majority of votes, and it's, and if it's received by the Senate, and if they equally vote for it, it will potentially, with the governor's support, go on the ballot.
Yes,
that's
and
what the fact
from,
is. From, and similarly,
and the fact is, I probably have a better chance of being Speaker tomorrow than that occurring. But you know, if I'm not allowed to ask questions, I'd like to be able to at least have my thoughts put forth.
You're making a comment about personal discussions in Democratic caucuses. I was just wondering, absent a hearing device, how you might know that. That's all.
Because I actually speak to people, and some of the members of your caucus actually don't believe that we should be kept in the dark about everything, Chairman. With respect to this particular bill, one of the things that, had we had open discussion, had we had the ability to ask any questions, one of the things that I would have actually liked to have discussed on this bill in particular is, right after this, we're going to be having a hearing on another constitutional amendment that is going to mandate quarterly pension payments into the state with revenue that everybody admits does not exist. And if we are looking to expand gaming in the state, why in God's name wouldn't we have discussed potentially allowing a portion of projected additional revenue to be utilized to pay some of these obligations rather than putting it towards additional pet projects in the future? And in fact, the way that this particular bill is drafted, we are constitutionally prohibited from using any of that excess cash flow to pay our pension obligations, as we're simultaneously having a hearing to mandate payment of obligations that we don't have the money for. So with respect to this particular bill, in the event that it is moot and it does move into the next session, I would ask the sponsors to potentially consider looking into, until our pension obligations stabilize a bit, maybe we can use some of that additional cash flow to pay that down without having to raise taxes against everybody in the state and make everybody else leave. Now, for purposes of the public's benefit, I just want to set the record straight on a couple of little things pertaining to this process. In the days prior to Christmas, there were two hastily called Judiciary Committee hearings that were made in an effort to change the New Jersey State Constitution with an unprecedented four constitutional amendments being pushed through. In my research, since the adoption of the New Jersey State Constitution, never have four amendments been pushed through in one committee, no less the way that this has transpired. In fact, the last time we had four constitutional amendments up was approximately 30 years ago. So, notwithstanding the process, we've been prepared to ask questions, hear testimony, have open, transparent debate and discussion, and do our jobs. And notwithstanding a couple of statements that have been made so far today that we have been given opportunity to ask questions and therefore that's why we're not going to be permitted to do so today, we have been specifically precluded from doing our job and asking questions. And in the upcoming two next hearings that we're going to have, we have never been permitted to ask one question of one witness for two of the most important issues that are coming before our state that are being put forth to change our Constitution. And so I want the public to understand how broken this process has been, how antithetical to good government this has been. And you know, I'd like to even ask OLS to research whether or not we have ever had a situation whereby a committee was permitted and members of the committee were prohibited from asking questions at a public hearing for constitutional amendments. fortunately or unfortunately, have sat on pretty much every controversial issue that's come forth in our state in the past 4 years. This is the first time I have ever sat and been prohibited from asking questions, and that is just wrong. I don't care what your political leanings are. Anyone who favors open, transparent, good government should really be appalled and reject what is transpiring here.
Do you have any comments on the bill? Are you finished?
I gave comments on the bill, Mr. Chairman.